Hey everybody, coming to you from Gateway Classic Cars over here outside of St. Louis, Missouri. And I thought you'd like a look at this 1952 Chevrolet pickup. This is a nice looking hot rod. We'll check it out here. You can see they've deleted the front bumper and painted in the grill slats just to make it all look nice and smooth. You can see that paint looks really slick on there. It is riding on some aftermarket aluminum wheels. Those look nice. Of course, in 52, they still have the divided windshield, as you can see. It still has the cowl vent in the factory location there. They've added some little hot rod peep style mirrors. Very nice. Still has the factory style running boards. I did notice they've shaved the door handles on it. It's kind of cool. Here, we'll take a look inside. You can see they've completely redone the interior. Nice new door panels. Has some tall back bucket seats. With a console there in the middle. It has a later model steering column in it. And they've added some Dolphin gauges as well. 140 mile per hour speedometer there on the left. And then it has a nice multi-gauge setup to the right. It does have air conditioning as well. I believe that's a vintage air unit. The dashboard is actually upholstered just like the rest of the interior. But it definitely looks like new in there. Very sharp. A nice smooth truck. Yeah, this hard tonneau cover on here with a piano hinge right there in the center. Pretty cool. Let's see if we can open that up for you. You can see that has all aluminum bracing under it. That's an aluminum tonneau cover. And the bed, they've completely redone with new wood slats and then the stainless steel trim in between. Very nice. And then you have the fuel tank out back now with this little fuel filler back here. That's pretty cool. Instead of like having it in the cab or something like that. That's definitely a nice setup. Let's go ahead and shut that down. It's even got kind of a little flush mounted latch here. And they've added some tail lights actually inside the little roll on the bed tube here. Pretty cool. They've also added blue dot taillights for a little hot rod touch there. And then they've removed the rear bumper and put this little louvered roll pan on it. But, I mean, as you can see, it's definitely a nice truck all the way around. It has a nice stance to it too. Very clean. Let's go ahead and take a look under the hood here. Alright, well that makes a good impression when you open the hood. You can see they have this big, tall, kind of almost velocity stack style air cleaner. Pretty cool. And that's sitting on an Edelbrock 4-barrel carb. And nice aluminum intake as well. Then they have the block and heads and valve covers all in the correct Chevy orange. I can see it has nice long tube headers on it as well. This thing sounds good too. They had it running just a little while ago and it sounds pretty impressive. See, it has the AC compressor up here, and it is the modern 134 air conditioning, of course. But I mean, I definitely thought it was pretty impressive when I first popped the hood open, so it's definitely looking sharp. They don't have all the information on the window yet, so I'll have to get that to you as it becomes available. This one just came off the truck. Jordan was telling me that the reason that it sounds so good is because those long tube headers are just running into some glass pack mufflers, and then the pipes actually turn out right out the sides, if you can see right there. So it definitely has a nice rumble to it. And that cam, it has a, you know, a mild cam in it too, I believe, because it has a nice little lope to it. But definitely an impressive truck. But anyway, guys, like I said, I'll add some information below the video when I get it. But I just thought it was worth taking a look at. I'm going to keep looking around and see what else they have. And I'll see you later. Bye.